Well, high cholesterol is one of the biggest risk factors for cardiovascular disease, and according to the Heart Foundation, more than 40% of Australian adults are living with the condition.
But one of the easiest ways to keep your cholesterol in check is through your diet, and here to tell us more is Sunrise nutritionist Sarah DiLorenzo. Good morning to you. Firstly, what is cholesterol? How does food impact it?
Okay, so cholesterol is a waxy substance that's produced in our liver. It's really important for things like our vitamin D, production of bile, and also our hormones. But how what we eat has a massive impact on our cholesterol levels. We know that if we have a poor diet, we're going to elevate the LDL, low-density lipoproteins, which is the bad cholesterol. But if we eat a healthy diet, we can actually keep our cholesterol levels in check. And then there is dietary cholesterol, so foods that contain cholesterol, and they actually just don't have an impact on us unless you're what's called a hyperabsorber. But anyway, so has a big impact, cholesterol. It's really interesting.
Right, OK. Well, that sounds a bit scary. What should we be eating?
OK. So definitely, so when patients come into my clinic, one of the first things I do is I get them to have half a cup of oats. And if you look at that over an 8-week period, you can bring down that LDL cholesterol. You can,
really?
Yeah, by about 15% over an 8-week period. It is amazing. And that is
just
because
with
of
oats.
Just with oats. Oh, well, a healthy diet as well, none of the rubbish too.
Oh, sure. Right.
Yeah, but it's really important. And that's because fibre in the diet helps regulate our cholesterol levels. There's a whole, I could go on a tangent about the liver and the bile pathway, but I won't because that's a couple of minutes. But I just want to point out fibre is really important. So apples as well as berries, the unsaturated fats in things like avocado and salmon, nuts, really important, chia seeds. Research shows even just 4 serves of fruit and vegetables, excellent for people to have, like, they generally will have a lower incidence of elevated cholesterol, and herbs and spices for the antioxidant support, and not to forget, green tea drinkers have a 20% lower incidence of cholesterol. For
there
those that have
that's
a cup a day, so it's
like
really
that.
Interesting.
Oh, just one cup a day.
One cup a day of green
tea.
Yeah, it was a great study done on that.
Eggs, break the myth for us.
Okay. This is, I love this, because people are obsessed with this egg cholesterol.
Okay.
This is information, nutritional information from 1970.
Right,
there is
forget it.
There is absolutely, it is a dietary cholesterol, so eggs do contain cholesterol, but we don't absorb it, okay, so unless you're a hyperabsorber. So they actually, a study showed that they actually increase what we call the good cholesterol, our HDL cholesterol. So eggs are completely fine. Enjoy your eggs. They are not going to elevate
How
your
many
cholesterol
can you
levels.
Have a day?
I always say to people, no more than 2. That would be my guidelines anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, but
eggs
are great.
Let's look at a day on the plate, starting with breakfast.
Okay, so breakfast always will be something definitely on my program would be oats. I've got it with some chia seeds there. They've got the omega-3, which is excellent. And I've also just put some berries on there just to bring the fruit in. Now, lunch. The key heroes here, I've got some tuna, but I've also got some hummus, the fibre and the unsaturated fats in a whole grain wrap. And for dinner, making sure you're getting the vegetable intake high. I've got like a chicken and broccoli stir fry, lots of herbs put through there. Another key hero there is ginger, which helps reduce cholesterol. Mm-hmm. And then you'd be snacking on things like nuts and seeds and fruit, even boiled eggs, and having a cup of green tea every day. So that's kind of what your day on a plate would look like, breakfast, lunch and dinner.
So when we have some spare time, what should we be eating?
If you have a look at these, what I would call food-like substances, I don't consider this food. The research actually shows that people over a 2-week period who had 25% of their diet from added sugar had a 17% increase in their bad cholesterol.
Wow.
So you can really see how it impacts. So all of this stuff, zero fibre, it won't help regulate your cholesterol levels, and this needs to be avoided if you really want to watch it. But diet does really play a huge role, as well as exercise and sleep and moderating alcohol, really important too. So all that stuff. So
moderating alcohol, like that.
I'm not going to ban it, but at the end of the day,
And of course, you can find all the recipes on the Sunrise website. Thanks, Sarah.